How's it going, guys? Drae here, and today we're going to be checking out a new game called Boundless. Now, this one is a brand new creative-focused survival game that obviously it takes some inspiration from Minecraft. The cool thing is, the art style is quite unique, and the way it does it is pretty cool. Basically, the majority of the players are on one world together, and they're literally shaping the world by actually building on it. So it looks really, really cool. I thought we'd give it a first look here. If you guys like it, we'll obviously check out some more of it. But first of all, I have to create my crazy character, and I don't know what these guys are. Kind of looks like a human and a cactus made a kid, and that's what popped out. So we have, oh man, okay, all these headpieces. Obviously, these are not totally humanoids. I kind of like the look of them, though. They have their own race type. Okay, I'm kind of digging the punk style here, and faces, I guess we can only have one now for some reason. There's 255 itints, guys. Yes, if you wanted itints in a game, this one has a lot of them. Why is there that many? That is just crazy. You know what? I'm going to do shadow green. Looks pretty damn cool. Body type, male or female. Character scale, I'm going to go somewhere in the middle. And again, we have 255 tints we can choose from. Let's go. I actually like the tints, though. They are very well done. I want to go for something a little more dark. I think that looks pretty cool. We're going to name ourselves, and let's get right into the game because that's... Oh, my God. Can I not type? What the hell's wrong with me? But, yeah, let's get right into the game because that's what everybody's here for. Creatures on these worlds may attack first. You know what? I'm up for a challenge. Let's try Hostile World, and here we are. So you can kind of see the art style here. Obviously, has inspiration from Minecraft, but what creative game doesn't these days? Yeah, this is a whole new genre now, and I gotta say, oh man, there's the world right there. So you can actually see, if you look really closely, it looks like there is some things being built on it, but yeah, that's the actual world. I guess this is kind of a tutorial right now. All right, we need to collect the totem and warp augments. So those are these things right here, and I think we gotta just equip these. So we'll put that on my left hand, and then we have to put the warp augment on my totem to apply it. Now we should be able to teleport. So yes, now we can see the world and we can actually warp wherever we put this thing. So obviously we can't go too deep. It looks like there's something over here. Obviously most people have been building right here, as you can see. Lord's Valley. That sounds kind of fun. So yeah, let's go somewhere where the people are. I don't know. Looks like there's actually, yeah, there's more people down here. Pallet Town's in the game. Oh no, we have to hold it. There we go. Now we have saved our warp location. So now we have these warp conduits here. We have to interact with them, I believe. Landing site, yes, that's the one I want to go to, and we are going to open the warp for free. Waiting for world data. Okay, break blocks to open. Oh, wow, that's actually really cool. So it's a legit portal to where I put on the world. Can we actually see the other way? Oh, yeah, we got something going on here. This is so cool. So we just walk right through. And now we're in the world. Here we go. Oh, man, we're already... Okay, so there's a little guy over there. We have to remember we are on a hostile world. So this guy looks like he wants to eat me. I'm going to go to where the people have built and try and get away from these guys for a second as we learn how to play. But check out this. So this is kind of what I was talking about when it's like an open world Minecraft, basically. Somebody has built a pub here. Let's go check out the pub. All right, not sure what this thing is. Obviously, there's going to be some crazy tech in this game. I want to go in the pub, though. See if I can maybe get a drink or something. Well, we have a spitter in the pub. That's not good. Okay, yeah. No, okay. I'll see you later. That pub doesn't like me. Okay, maybe going to a hostile world wasn't the best idea. I didn't expect to see creatures. Oh, God. Drogo? Is that an actual player? What's up, Drogo? How you doing, buddy? Yeah, you know what? I'm going to try and make a friend request to Drogo here. Drogo waved at me. I guess he doesn't want to be my friend, though. So, yeah, I'm just going to leave you alone. I'm still learning the game, Drogo. I'll see you later, buddy. Somebody built a damn treehouse here. This looks amazing. What I love so much about games like this is just looking at people's creativity. I mean, I suck at it, but we have a whole town here of people that are actually building stuff that looks really, really good. So I might try and build around here. We have to go kind of get some materials and whatnot. So I'm going to go to the outskirts and see if we can chop some trees down or something. Well, it looks like I got a reward for, I guess, living? I have no idea. We're gonna open... Oh, man. Okay, we're opening this thing up. I'm in the middle of nowhere right now. We got some coins, got some qubits, and we got some XP. So, I'm quickly learning this game's quite in-depth. Like, we have attributes, life and protection. Like, this can get pretty deep, which is surprising considering, you know, I kind of considered this one to be more childlike, but, if it has depth, that is great. Now, I'm kind of just doing the tutorial right now. And yeah, hopefully by the end of this, we can build up our own little civilization here. Oh, somebody's trying to kill me here. Could I get trapped down there? I probably could. So with those qubits, we can get a 2-plot wood coffer. Not really sure what that is, but it wants me to get it. So I guess this is another one that we can open up and get. Okay, so it looks like the plot is the way for people to not totally destroy anything that I create. Basically, I can put this plot down and I guess not allow people to attack it or destroy it or anything. All right, we got some remnants of some trees here. I didn't really want to leave the civilization and go out into the open, so I guess we have to break some tree blocks here and get some resources. And now we need some foliage, so looks like we can get multiples off one place, so that's nice. And what are we going to do with this? Handcraft a campfire. That sounds exciting. I'm kind of thinking maybe I should even, like, chill up here. We have a good view of the place. Good old Lord's Valley. I actually really do like it. So yeah, I think we'll go up here. Ready to craft, open up E in the inventory, and go to handcraft. So we want to make a campfire. All right, so we have our campfire in our hand, and it looks like we can just put it... Whoa, that was weird. Okay, so yeah, that's going to be our safe area. This is where nobody else can build. So there we go. Now I got it. And my little blue area, nobody can build in. So look at that. All right, and then you actually have a home part on your map, so that's really cool. And it looks like this will last for 2 hours until you have to relight it. I'm assuming later on you can get something that will keep it forever, but as I am a new character, it's only going to last 2 hours, and then somebody else can build here unless I keep building. Now, I get some more rewards, I think. Ah, yes, we got a couple of them here. Oh, we got a stone level one now, too. We keep getting these things, so this must be a common occurrence. That's all right. I'm all about getting those free coins. We're leveling up as well, getting stronger, which is good because there's some evil monsters on this mountain that I don't want to screw with. I just keep getting them. I don't know what I'm getting them for. I guess leveling up would make sense. Yes, we got another stone one. Man, I'm just going to level up with these things. So next thing we want to do is make a crafting table. You know what? We got some trees over there. I want to go explore down here as well. I've been looking at this place. It looks really cool, so... Oh, okay, you know what? I'm thinking these guys are not going to be that bad. Wild stock. I don't even think they're going to attack me. So, what about you? Oh, crap. You're the spitter. You're the evil jerk that's been hitting me. All right, come on. Bring it on, spitter. I love how peaceful the characters look in this game. I mean, he's adorable, but he's been pissing me off, too. So, let's get him down here. Get some XP in the bank and see what we can loot off him. I guess it automatically loots. Now, what did that give me? Ah, we got some blood. That's great. Always nice to have some blood in the bag. Oh, man, this guy's got a freaking cave. He has a mine right beside his place. Now, that's smart if I've ever seen it. I wonder if I can open this up. I just want to see what's inside. Yes, I can. All right, looks pretty damn barren in here, to be honest. I don't know what these things are, but this is clearly just a house or something. All right, but that's what I needed, some random wood blocks on the mountain over here. So we're hitting for 210 damage now. I have been using my stats, which seems to be that I can even collect faster, which is kind of cool. So yes, now it wants me to make a crafting table. So I got some twisted wood timber. I can craft required. I can only craft 2? Oh, man, this is gonna... Wait. Oh, it looks like I could just do it... All right, there we go. I thought I could only craft 2, but no, I can craft 26. Okay, so now we can go make our crafting table. That should be good enough for right now. That's actually a lot of timber. So back home we go. Oh, I didn't even notice. Like, right above my home, you can see my little fire over there. I got freaking Death Tower above me. That's kind of horrifying looking. Oh, I am dumb. Wow, there is some serious fall damage in this game. Well, that sucks. God damn. damn it. I guess we're gonna get back to where we were and try that again. All right, back to home sweet home. Now you do respawn kind of close to where you died, which is kind of cool. So you don't really lose much aside from your items. Now let's make a crafting table, shall we? All right, and there we go. So we got our crafting table in our hand. This is kind of cool. You can actually, if you look at the far right outside of the screen, you can hold 8 different items in your hand, and then you use your scroll wheel to just spin around to select them. I actually like the way this inventory works. Instead of the numbers, you just use your scroll wheel. So yeah, there we go. Let's put the crafting table right. Oh, okay, I'll take that. I forgot, it's right click when you have it in the right hand. But there we go, we got a crafting table. Now let's see what we can do with this. As you can see, a lot of building. Surprise, surprise, that's what crafting tables are for. All right, you can actually mine this barbed grass and you get barbed grass seeds, but it also goes away, which is pretty damn cool. So I guess you can farm this stuff if you want. I mean, I don't think anybody would really want to. I don't really know what it's for. But there we go. Now it's at least a little bit more open. All right, now it wants me to get some tools. So, of course, I would like to do that. I got all the required materials. So, wood hammer. Let's, oh, you can bulk. You can bulk craft 3 and you can mass craft. This is really cool. So, we're going to craft 1. I only want 1 right now. But if you are running a village or something, it would be smart to craft multiples. Wood axe. There we go. Crafting seems to be instantaneous in this game, so kind of cool, I guess. Okay, so I guess they have the crafted items on the table. We just have to move these over to our inventory, and there we go. We got all the required tools. So if I go in here, we can put these, for example, all... This is so cool. This is a lot of extra space, and we can just scroll wheel to choose those. Really, really cool, as you can see. Now we should be able to... Yeah, get some rock, as you can see, and it won't, you know, totally destroy my equipment. So we got rock all over us. I'm just going to collect some resources here and see what we can do with them. All right, this new axe is great for getting foliage as well. So there's that going for us. I'm actually running out of stamina here. Should we try? Let's see how quickly the shovel is. So we need to shovel for getting dirt, for example, and 315. So each one of these basic weapons hits for 315 as compared to the 200 that my totem was hitting for. Oh, we hit some gravel here. So I've just been mining to see the different types of rock. There's actually, even when it comes to rock, there's so many different types. It looks like gravel's extremely hard to get. Not really sure what it's for, but you can see we got metamorphic rock down here. We got sedimentary rock over here. And I'm assuming when you go deeper, you get into the ores and whatnot. I thought we would just mine just a little bit. It wants me to craft something. I guess we'll, what can we craft? We can make a warp stone or conduit. The beacon. So you can use the campfire and then you can upgrade to the beacon. And I guess the beacon also uses fuel, but I'm assuming it lasts longer than the campfire. So I'm gonna craft one of those and hopefully we can last a little bit longer. Let's also craft some fuel for it. What else do we have in here? We got lots of different types of materials. When it comes to crafting areas, we've already made the table. We can do furnace bases. Crucibles, what does that do? The top half of a simple furnace place it. Oh, it's the top half. Okay. And then we also have another workbench, so it probably gets more complex than this one. All right, there we go. So we got our fire. Now we got a beacon. Now, how long does this last? Fueled for 1 hour and 36 minutes. I'm assuming, though, if I add that fuel to it, let's put that on my bar as well. Collected beacon revenue. So I guess you can earn money by doing this as well. I can't put beacon fuel on it. So is it really only 2 hours as well? Ah, there we go. We have a fuel tab on this. So now, as you can see, it's going to be here for almost a month. Well, actually, more specifically, like, exactly a month. So... yeah, it's probably a good thing that I made that. Wait, it says fueling for 1 hour 36 minutes, though. I'm so confused. Oh, I have to add it. Okay, there we go. Now I've officially made this place my home for at least a month. So that's a really smart way to get rid of inactive people, too. Slowly, you'll lose your thing if you don't log in and add fuel. Really smart idea. All right, so I made some beacon plotters, and it looks like as you level up, you can add more to your zone. So, as you can see, currently I have that little square. What I actually want to do, I think, is maybe make some sort of mine. So I'm going to add one here. I currently made 2, so we're expanding out our zone a little bit. This is really cool. So as you level up, you can own more of the land, basically, so you can't just troll as a noob. So next, we're gonna need some food. This is a survival game after all. Oh yeah, I never actually looked at the Dark Tower. Oh my god. What are you doing to my mountain? Oh, he's building into the mountain, the little turd. Okay, so I was gonna build into the mountain, but I guess this guy beat me to the punch. But yeah, I wanna make a sling bow so we can go maybe hunt some food. I can probably forage food as well. Man, this thing is totally destroyed. Somebody, I was either trolling him or he's building his thing too big. And there's a lot of openings out there. I can't even... Well, you know what, dude? I'm just gonna have to do this. I'm sorry. Let's also use the right tool, the wood shovel. There we go. And I just want to see if I can open this thing. I mean, this is a really cool little tower here. Yeah, he's got some stuff in here. Looks like he's got, like, these storage bins. I don't... That looks really high-tech to me. That's really cool. Okay, this is stuff that I have no... I mean, it looks like these are all machines. Not really sure what they do, but really cool to see the different type of things you can make in this game. And look at that, we're at the top. You can see the whole world from here. So I need some wood to make the sling bow. So we're gonna collect some wood real quick here. Now the one thing I do not like about this game is with most games like this, when you chop the bottom of a tree, it vanishes because stuff like this happens then. And I gotta be honest, it kinda looks ugly when you're just seeing this. I mean, don't get me wrong, the towns look great, but the actual outlands where people collect their resources, it's a mess out here. So I hope they can change this or maybe do it in a different way. Maybe over time these trees degrade or something, because that would be much smarter and it wouldn't look so bad when you're out just seeing this. All right, but now we should have everything for a stone sling bow. I actually can make 18 recipes now, so I clearly needed sticks for a lot of things. We could actually make part of the furnace if we wanted to. I'm more interested in exploring right now. We're also getting into doors and everything. I don't remember those being in there. Anyways, what we want is up here. We have other items as well, chisels, things like that, but I want a weapon. So we are going to craft this, and it's going to take me 30 seconds to get that. And then we got to go get some food, because I'm low energy right now, man. Actually, can I eat this thing? It's a raw something. I mean, the fact that it's raw tells me I can eat it, so... Oh. Yeah, I don't know where I got that, but that gave me a little bit of energy at least. That's good. I wonder if I can get some meat, though. There we go. My thing is done. Throw that in my inventory, and I don't know if this thing needs, like, shots or anything. I guess we'll find out real quick. We'll put it on our bar here and move over to it, so... No, it does. Oh my god, that's really cool. Okay, so let's go hunting. Got a mine down here of some sort. I'm gonna go hunting in town, actually, because I know there's creatures there. Oh, we got a spitter right here. Look at this little jerk. Come on, bring it on, bro. Bring it on. There we go. Bob and weave. The spitters. Oh, man, he's spitting like crazy. I don't know. Oh, yeah, they do drop meat. So can I just eat this raw? I'm assuming I have to cook it or something, but raw meat. You know what? Screw it. Let's try. It's probably not safe to eat it, but... I'm gonna do it anyways. And whoa, we are sick now. Okay, that was not smart. You should probably cook your meat, guys. Uh-oh. The music's creepy. That's because I'm sick. I'm totally out of health. This is not good. I died. I shouldn't have ate raw food. Damn it! Now we have another fellow player. It looks like, is this a store? I think, yeah, somebody set up shop here. Oh, we got another guy down here too. Storage block. Oh, sorry. No, these are storage blocks. I know people can make stores, though. Looks like this one's still being built. Yeah. So I guess you can actually see what's inside the storage blocks. We got a lot of people around here, actually. Kind of cool to see actual players around doing their own thing. Okay, you know what? I've started foraging. I think this is the smarter idea at the start, because I think this thing right here, this is the thing that gave me that fruit. Let me see. Oh, yeah. That's definitely where I got that fruit from. So... You don't need to eat meat, and we obviously have to figure out a way to cook it first. So, yeah, may as well forage. Oh, we do got guys over there, though. You know what? It's just, I really like this weapon, so let's try and shoot this again. You have to judge distance. It's got a crazy bullet drop. Oh, man, he's charging me. These little guys are so cute. Oh, God. Oh, don't you do it. Oh, he pushed me. I don't know if you saw that, but he actually pushed me. So we got some bones off that guy. That's not really going to give us what we need, though. So we should have got... Oh, yeah, we got three of these things now. So I think I can eat the earth yams without getting sick. That didn't affect me. Yeah, so we're good. We can live off earth yams if we do need to. And there we go. We got lots of energy. All right, so I think you guys get the idea. I did want to check out one more place before I end off this video. That giant tower, we have to be able to get inside of it. It looks I can't even see it. There's just so much crap over here. There's the tree place again. Probably one of my favorite ones. Look at this. I don't know what's inside here, but it feels like this is like the king or something of this whole town. And everywhere I look, there's just so much more creations. It's really cool to just walk around and see what people have been doing. Oh my god. I mean, look at this. I'm trying to find the damn tower. Where is it? You know what? This kind of looks like a staircase here, possibly. We might have to come inside this place. Yes, and there we go. I figured it out, guys. Oh my god, this looks so epic. And here we go, climbing up the place. It looks absolutely crazy in here. A little bit messy, but kind of organized oddly enough as well. At least I can figure out where I need to go. All right, guys, and on that, we're going to wrap up this one here. So I hope you guys enjoyed checking out Boundless. Now, I don't know if I'm going to do any more on this. We obviously did make a little encampment. You can actually see it right below Dark Tower over there. But yeah, there's a lot of creative games out there. If you guys like this, we'll definitely do some more. But yeah, I just wanted to show you it in case you're a fan of these. And I got to say, this is one of the coolest ones I've seen. So yeah, once again, guys, thanks so much for your support. Thanks for watching and liking. And I'll see you in the next one.